Krebs, get up here.
What?
There's a German squad by that bridge. We're going to take it out. There's a cluster of trees over there. Give us some cover.
Was ist das, mein Herr?
Contact artillery vehicle. Haben wir new coordinate 10.
Ihr wollt hören was.
Wait for my signal. Thanks about that.
Don't talk. Just rest. We gotta get you to a field hospital.
I think they set one up near Bonn.
That's still far away, and we're still close to the front. What was that?
MG! Go! No!
Let's bring it. Comrade.
I don't want to talk about it.
But I want to hear.
It's okay, Harold. We understand. Run along now, Helen. Is there something you want to talk about, Harold?
No, I don't know.
We're all so happy you're home. I'll tell your grandmother. See if she wants to come for dinner.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Wait, can it wait until tomorrow?
Yes, that'd be fine, dear. But I'll tell your dad, he'll be so excited when he comes home.
What else do you need to know?
What?
That book. It's about the war. We were there. What else do you need to know?
I don't know. I like it. It makes me think.
I hate hearing about the war. I don't like to think about it.
I like it. Look at the maps and the people other than us. It makes me feel like I'm a part of something bigger, you know?
That makes sense.
I wish there was more maps, though.
There will be someday. I think people are going to be writing books about us for a long time. It's changed a lot here.
I don't think so.
What do you mean? The things people do and have?
I think it's just us that have changed. People treat us different. My dad still has the same job, the same car, we live in the same house.
The girls have changed.
Yeah, but that's normal. We've been gone for 4 years.
It's just supposed to be gradual, you know? It's kind of a shock. I wish we'd gotten home sooner. I really want a girlfriend. You know, start a new life.
I don't know.
You don't want one?
Well, of course I do. I just don't want to do all that work. I live in a world of complicated alliances, shifting feuds. It takes so much work to break into that system. I just wish they could come right to us, right?
Well, good luck with that.
I'm serious.
I'm sure you are, but you'll have to do work someday.
I wish I didn't. I don't want to do any work right now. I just want life to be less complicated, you know? You have friends, you do your job, you do what you're told, nothing else.
Like in the army.
I guess so.
If you change your mind, I'll be at the bar tonight at 9:30.
I'll think about it, but nothing's changing.
Oh,
Say cheese.
Good game.
You too.
I haven't lost like that in years. One more game?
No, I'm done.
Hey.
Hi.
I haven't seen you here before.
I just got home.
From the...
Yep.
Oh.
You never told me that.
Well, it's not something I like to talk about.
No one does. It's just a bunch of horror stories.
No, it's just...
Anyways, can I buy you a drink, babe? That's a new story.
Yeah, it is. So there's this small town in France called Nadine.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. What do you mean?
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
No, I don't. Sorry, I...
You do not have the Medal of Honor.
It was just a story.
Yeah, they thought it was true.
It was.
Yeah, but it didn't happen to you.
It's harmless.
Do you remember who told us that story? Do you?
It was David.
It was David Johnson. Do you remember what happened to him? He was killed in Bastogne. Shot through the head. He's not coming home, Harold. He was awarded the medal, not you. It's not your story, and pretending it was an insult to his memory. He was a good man, and he did not die so you could hook up with a random girl in the bar.
It was a story.
Go home, Krebs. Sorry about that. David was my friend. I just got emotional.
I understand. He was my friend too.
Why did you do that?
I don't know. I guess I'm just tired of people ignoring me. I don't want to talk about the war, but at the same time I do. I don't get it either.
I think I might. Nobody who was there wants to relive those experiences. But they all want them to be acknowledged, I guess. Maybe that story will help you get that girl. If you've changed your mind, I think she kind of likes you.
I don't know. My mom would like that.
You can't stay here forever, you know. Sometime you'll have to get a job, get a family.
I know that. But I hope it'll wait a few years.
So I had a talk with your father last night. He's willing for you to take the car out in the evenings.
Take the car out? Yeah.
Yes, your father has felt for some time that would be all right, but we just talked about it last night.
I bet you made him.
No, it was his suggestion.
I bet you made him.
Are you coming down for breakfast?
Yep, as soon as I get changed.
Well, Harry, you sleepyhead, what do you even get up for?
Do you have the paper?
Harold, don't muss the paper. Your dad can't read it if it's mussed.
I won't muss it, Mom. Don't worry.
We're playing ball at school this afternoon.
Oh, really? How's the old wing?
Well, I can pitch better than lots of the boys. I tell them you taught me. The other girls aren't much good.
Yeah?
I tell them you're my beau. Aren't you my beau?
You bet.
Am I really a girl?
Uh-huh.
Do you love me?
Uh-huh.
Will you always love me?
Sure.
Will you come watch me play ball?
Maybe.
Oh, Harry, you don't love me. If you loved me, you'd come.
You run along, Helen. I want to talk to Harold. I wish you'd put down the paper a minute, Harold. Have you decided what you're going to do yet?
No.
Don't you think it's about time?
I had thought about it.
God has some work for everyone to do in His kingdom.
I'm not in His kingdom.
Well, we're all in His kingdom, Harold. I've worried about you so much. I know the temptations that you face in war. Your grandfather told us about his actions in the Civil War. We fear you've lost your ambition, that you've got no aim in life. Charlie Simmons, who's your age, he's a job and he's getting married. Everyone is starting to settle down. And you're not sure what you want to do yet. You can see Charlie's going to be a credit to your community. Don't look that way. We know we love you. We just want what's best for you. Your father doesn't want to hamper your freedom. He's willing to let you out with the car if you take some nice girl. He would only be too pleased. We want you to have some fun, to settle down sometime. We don't care what you do, but we just want you to do something. Your father wants you to stop by his office to speak to him.
Is that all?
Don't you love your mother, dear boy?
I don't love anyone. I didn't mean it. Can you believe me?
Me?
Yes, Harold. I believe you.
I'm sorry.
Will you pray with me, Harold?
I can't.
Do you want me to pray for you?
Yes.
Your father still needs to talk to you, so drop by his office.
Okay.
Tell him I said hi.
Thank you.